Will we ever overtake Voyager 1? In the entire history of humanity, only 5 spacecraft have had the correct trajectory needed to exit the solar system. The first to leave our solar system was the Voyager 1 spacecraft, which already has a head start over the others. But will any spacecraft ever overtake Voyager 1? Let's talk about that and more in this video.
What is the most massive galaxy in the universe? Hard to say, but we can tell you which is the most massive in the local group. The local group is one of many galaxy clusters in the universe and the home of our Milky Way. For a long time, it was thought that our neighbor, the Andromeda Galaxy, had the most mass. It is bigger, has more stars, and so on. The latest research, however, assumes that our Milky Way has the most mass, although it has about 600 billion stars less. However, the most mass contributes the dark matter, and of it our Milky Way possesses clearly more. Was this short fact interesting for you? Well, it was presented by today's sponsor of the video, Infinity. Infinity is a free newsletter that regularly provides you with exciting articles on the topics of space, nature, technology, and the latest from the world of science. Short and compact so that everyone understands it. Stay up to date on the latest discoveries and get interesting facts you didn't know yet. Of course, with unique storytelling, so it will not be boring for you. Sometimes there are also exclusive interviews with interesting personalities who can give you insider and background knowledge on the topics. It's the newsletter for all dreamers. Click on the link in the description and sign up for free.
If you want to escape the solar system, you need much more than a normal spacecraft, and you must escape the combined gravitational pull of the Sun and the Earth. Although the Earth has a significant gravitational force, forcing an item at the surface to move at 11 km per second to escape our planet's gravitational attraction, the Sun's gravitational impact dominates the solar system. To depart the solar system fully, then, an object would need to travel at a speed of 42 km per second from Earth's orbit. And only 5, or 6 if you're charitable, spacecraft in human history have satisfied those requirements. These 5 spacecraft are the Pioneer 10 and Pioneer 11, New Horizons, and finally the 2 Voyager probes, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. The first Pioneer 10 was launched about half a century ago from the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida, on March 2, 1972. About the size of a car, the quarter-ton Pioneer 10 spacecraft was planned to investigate the entire solar system environment beyond Mars for the first time, including the never-crossed-before asteroid belt. Pioneer 10 would travel towards the outer solar system after passing Jupiter, eventually leaving the Sun's domain forever. NASA's Pioneer 10 and 11 spacecraft assisted in discovering the furthest reaches of our solar system. Though the missions launched about a year apart and traveled on different paths, they accomplished a number of historical feats together. Pioneer 10 provided unprecedented insight into the asteroid belt and performed the first flyby of Jupiter, while Pioneer 11 was the first spacecraft to fly by Saturn. NASA has lost touch with both spacecraft, but both have continued to travel further into space. Both Pioneer 10 and 11 are on paths that will ultimately lead them out of the solar system, each bringing a map back to Earth in the event that any intelligent life intercepts them. Pioneer 10 was humanity's first spacecraft to encounter Jupiter. The gravitational assist accelerated it beyond escape velocity. The most amazing aspect of Pioneer 10's journey is that it obtained virtually the maximum conceivable velocity from a gravitational collision with Jupiter. After becoming the first spacecraft to reach Jupiter in late 1973, it went on to become the first spacecraft in the solar system to attain escape velocity. It was our most distant spacecraft until 1998, when Voyager 1 surpassed it, and it will slip into third place in 2023, when Voyager 2 catches up with it as well. Pioneer 11, which was launched in 1973, is also leaving the solar system. Pioneer 11, like Pioneer 10, passed through Jupiter's lunar system before utilizing Jupiter's gravity as an aid maneuver to reach Saturn. It detected and almost crashed with Saturn's moon Epimetheus while investigating the Saturnian system, missing it by an estimated 4,000 kilometers. But despite encountering Saturn and Jupiter, it is our slowest outgoing spacecraft. Voyager 1 was launched on September 5, 1977, nearly 2 weeks after Voyager 2. The two probes completed a historic grand tour of the outer planets, providing scientists with some of the first close-up views of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, and their moons. The spacecraft is already 135 times farther away from the Sun than we are, and it will travel another 100 miles in the time it takes for me to read this line. The most recent observations raise concerns about the real extent of our solar system. Even though Pluto is considered as the outermost planet in our solar system, Voyager 1 is about 3 times further away from that, and yet is still inside the Sun's domain. Our powerful Sun is presently shining brighter than 10 full moons on the spacecraft. The reason this is happening is because the Sun extends its sphere of influence beyond the visible spectrum of light by ejecting a wind of particles which envelops the planets in a protective bubble known as the heliosphere. No one knows how big this bubble is, which explains the excitement with a Voyager's probe. Back in 2004, Voyager 1 began to detect hints that the end of the solar system was approaching, causing scientists to infer that the edge of the solar system is approaching. The solar wind should drastically slow when it presses against the universe beyond, and Voyager 1 saw precisely that. In 2007, Voyager's twin probe, Voyager 2, observed the same phenomenon. Another sign of departure was observed by Voyager 1 back in 2012. The amount of interstellar cosmic rays has increased, possibly because the Sun's magnetic field can no longer deflect large amounts of high-speed charged particles. Astronomers were able to know that Voyager 1 had left the heliosphere when the magnetic field lines flipped. In 2012, Voyager 1 breached the heliosphere barrier, and in 2018, Voyager 2 accomplished the same. The asymmetric nature and extent of the bubble has not been fully measured, particularly in the directions opposite the Voyager probes. It has been receding 17 kilometers per second since entering interstellar space in 2012. Before running out of fuel in 2025, the spacecraft will investigate the local cloud, a wisp of cosmic flotsam that absorbs traces of light from neighboring stars. The cloud is a cosmic wonder, not a permanent feature, but it has an effect on the size of the heliosphere. It compresses it, but only a little because the cloud is dispersed. In the past, thick clouds might have compressed the heliosphere so much that Earth was exposed to cosmic radiation that could have aided or hampered the genesis of life. Our home planet is unquestionably a component of the solar system. Hence, any limit that excludes Earth cannot be considered the system's outer limits. Voyager 2 notably performed a grand tour of the solar system, traveling near to each of the 4 gas giants and photographing their planetary, lunar, and ring systems. To do this, Voyager 2 was launched on a slower trajectory than Voyager 1. Despite being the first to be launched, it is less far and faster than its sibling. And the latest in our list of interstellar probes is the New Horizons spacecraft, which was launched back in 2006 and is our fastest spacecraft ever. In July 2015, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft became the first to visit the minor planet Pluto. New Horizons continues to explore our solar system, and on April 17, 2021, this spacecraft will have traveled 50 astronomical units from the Sun. An astronomical unit is the typical Earth-Sun distance, which is around 93 million miles, or 150 million kilometers. New Horizons observations continue to redefine our knowledge of the solar system and the objects circling distant from the Sun. Because of its tremendous distance from Earth, this spacecraft is just the 7th to journey so far from home. But will the fastest spacecraft, New Horizon, ever catch or overtake Voyager 1? The short answer is no. Despite getting a boost by Jupiter during its journey to Pluto, it won't be able to catch Voyager 1. The New Horizons spacecraft was somewhat accelerated, but primarily diverted into a trajectory that would lead to a close flyby encounter with Pluto. Because it lacks a significant gravity assist, its speed will never allow it to catch up to Voyager 1 or 2. This 1997 artwork depicts the planets of the solar system as well as the respective paths of the solar system's first 4 spacecraft. Voyager 1 passed Pioneer 10 in 1998, and it passed the heliopause and reached the interstellar space in 2012. Voyager 2 entered interstellar space in 2018 and will not pass Pioneer 10 until 2023. So we have a strong suspicion that Pioneer 10 is also in interstellar space, but is no longer operational. New Horizons, which was just 20 astronomical units away from the Sun at the time, is now more than 150% further, at over 50 AU. It will eventually pass both Pioneers, but never either Voyager. Although Pioneer 10 was the first spacecraft launched in 1972 on a course that would take it outside the solar system, it was exceeded in 1998 by Voyager 1, and will be surpassed again in 2023 by Voyager 2 and New Horizons in the late 2100s. The Ulysses spacecraft, launched in 1990, was planned to circle the Sun and study it from various latitudes and distances. A gravitational collision with Jupiter in 2098 will give a gravitational push strong enough to propel Ulysses out of the solar system. No other mission will be able to surpass Voyager 1. Also, there is simply no reason to overtake the Voyagers. NASA plans their missions meticulously without wasting taxpayer dollars, so they wouldn't want to plan a mission just to overtake the Voyager 1. We have and will have spacecrafts faster than the Voyagers, but there might be simply no reason to just launch them in a race. Apart from this, there is also another ignored reason. Space is enormously large and three-dimensional. Many of us are accustomed to seeing the familiar solar system diagram, with its dots for planets in near-circular orbits, neatly arranged around the central circle representing the Sun. We forget that none of those elliptical orbits are actually coplanar with the ecliptic, and that the majority of the interplanetary probe orbits are well outside the ecliptic plane. Pioneer 11 being the first of these, and Voyager 1 and 2 and New Horizons have followed suit. Each of the five vessels departing our solar system is traveling in a different direction and at a different angle to the ecliptic. So there's no reason to compare these spacecraft as a one-directional linear race. In the coming future, even if we have very fast spacecrafts, they wouldn't be sent on a mission to overtake the Voyagers. So we can comfortably say that Voyager 1 would always be the furthest man-made object out in interstellar space. So what do you think about Voyager 1? Will we ever overtake it? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. And press the bell notification icon so you don't miss out on updates about humanity's voyage into the cosmos.